Hello everyone, a very warm welcome to the introduction session, the introduction webinar on our online course on daylight simulation using Rhino and Grasshopper. We are very happy to do this webinar for two reasons. One is that we've got so many questions and interest in this program that it really called for one such session where we talk about the program in detail and walk you through what is going to be covered in the program, who is it for, and so on. And also give you the chance to ask any queries or any clarifications you may want to have with us. So this is a little interaction session for both of us, and hopefully you get all your questions clarified by the end of this session. So first things first, there are two of us here on this webinar session today. Myself, Deepa, I'm an architect and I'm practicing as a green building consultant. I lead the sustainability education programs and different initiatives at EDS. I've been in this space for more than 10 years, working with EDS and other firms as well. And with me, I have my colleague, Vaishali. She's also an architect and a green building analyst. Vaishali will kind of introduce herself a little bit more when she gets to explain the program in detail. So we thought first we give you a little insight about what EDS is, Environmental Design Solutions, right? Maybe some of you know about it, but for the benefit of others, just a little throwing some light on the work we do. EDS is a sustainability consulting firm in the built environment. This is a photo of our office in Delhi. This is where our head office is. We are a team of 65 plus professionals, including architects and engineers. The firm was established in 2003, and over the years, we've completed more than 400 projects. Some more pictures of our office in Delhi. This is kind of in a semi-basement space, and you can see that these pictures kind of reflect our work culture and kind of what we believe in. There is a lot of recycled material used inside the space, so it kind of reflects our ethos. And being in the sustainability consulting space, we kind of walk the talk when it comes to our own office space. So when you are in Delhi, just come by and say hi to us. Of course, when everyone is resuming work soon. So we are also located in Mumbai and Pune in India. And outside of India, we're located in Bangladesh. And we have a presence in Netherlands and Washington, D.C. as well. EDS is a proven provider under specifically for LEED BDC and O&M certification systems. It means that our work has been approved and certified for a certain quality. For the LEED documentation. EDS is also an education partner, and we provide educational content for professional development, which is all hosted on the USGBC education platform. So some of our colleagues, as I mentioned, we are 65 plus team. Some of us are LEED APs, LEED Green Associates. We also have a LEED Fellow, IGBC AP, True Professionals, Griha Professionals, Certified Measurement and Verification Professionals, WELL AP, and so on. So we have a diverse team, which, and with credentials in a lot of different areas, which, under the sustainability umbrella. Now, a little bit brief about the scope of services that we offer, starting with high performance building design, This includes buildings that are aiming for net zero or any other high performance benchmark. So we provide consulting for such projects. Next is policy advisory. So that includes working with the government government bodies and even international organizations like World Bank, UNEP, UNDP, and so on. And working on, again, things to do in the realm of sustainability. An example is our team had worked on the Energy Conservation Building Code 2017 of India, and we were instrumental in, you know, working on the latest update for the code. Commissioning and audit for existing building, one of our teams specializes in that. Building performance simulation, of course, is integral to high performance building consulting. We use advanced simulation tools and we provide inputs to a design process at various stages, including daylight, energy, natural ventilation, CFD simulations, and so on. Next comes technology services. Our team leverages the skill of scripting into developing new tools and dashboards for clients. And finally comes capacity building and education. So here we've been doing a, you know, plenty of training programs, online courses, even in blended learning formats, and also providing tailor-made custom programs for corporate organizations and various educational institutions as well. So just throwing a little bit light on the education work that we do, because right now we are going to talk about the online course. So here are some of the photos from our online programs from the past. Sorry, the face-to-face programs from the past. You can see the little picture on the left side in the middle. It's a training kit with a 3D model. This workshop, the photos of this workshop was about daylight and energy simulation. And we really believe that even though the workshop is about simulation, it's very crucial to first get the fundamentals in place. A lot of participants would know about it, but just doing a refresher is absolutely crucial to link the theory to simulation tool, which eventually helps one apply the same concepts in practice. So we believe in a lot of this hands-on approach. And this essentially captures our essence of the content that we develop, whether it's for online format or it's for a face-to-face training program format. The content is designed such that you get to learn the concepts in the most simple and clear manner, so that you feel empowered to apply that in practice or in teaching or any sphere of your work. And by doing that, you will be able to be, you know, relevant and continue with your professional development. So that is the spirit with which we have been developing content for our program. So we bring in our professional expertise with the teaching skills and kind of bridge that gap between theory and practice. And that's how you know, our course content stays fresh and current. So here's a little snapshot of different online courses that we have, you know, under the umbrella of sustainability, ranging from water and waste and daylight and so on. We have 70 plus courses, which are approved for more than 45 GBCI credits, since we are US GBC education partners. We've also translated some of these courses in various languages, like Urdu, Bangla, Spanish, even Chinese. A couple of them are in Chinese too. And these are all audio video courses. And of course, the topic is quite diverse. Now, in the online blended learning program, we've already, we've offered these four topics. Climate Responsive Design, Early Design Optimization Using OpenStudio, Lead GA Exam Prep, and now in a week, Daylight Simulation course as well. So you can see that even these courses have a kind of diversity. Some are focused very much on teaching a simulation tool, and some like GA Exam Prep is more to do with giving the exam. So that's nothing to do with the tool. And Climate Responsive is kind of combines a little theory and a little tool, but it's a very beginner level course. So whatever may be the topic, we do bring in the element of the practical world, you know, which we get from our professional expertise. So that's the same spirit in which we are bringing to you the Daylight Simulation course using computational tools of Rhino and Grasshopper. It's a 2-week course. It'll start on 21st September. Now, everyone who is logged in here in the webinar is, of course, familiar with this course, and you have some questions in mind, and hence you are, you know, tuned into this program. So I thought, why don't we just get a sense of where everyone is at before we dive into the details of the program itself. So there is a little Q&A for you, and it will show up on your screen right now. All you have to do is just select the most fitting answer and send in your votes so we can all know who is doing what and who's familiar with what. So the first question here is, are you currently working on projects that need daylight assessment? I will share the results in a bit so everybody can know who we have in this room, right? So I'll wait for a minute. You can send in your poll response, and you know, we'll see who is the audience that we are talking to. Right, so 40 seconds is up. Most of you have voted. I'll wait for a few more seconds. If anyone is, you know, a little late entrant into the webinar, you can probably see it now. Okay, 5 more seconds and we'll close the poll. Right, so let's close the poll and share the results. Right, so here on your screen, 53% of you are not right now working on projects that kind of need daylight assessment of any kind. Whereas 27% is saying yes, and then the others currently no, and most of you plan to do so in the future. So that's interesting. So a lot of you are probably new to this area of daylight assessment. So that brings me to the next question I have coming up right now on your screen. Are you familiar with daylight simulations, even though your project may not require it right now? But are you familiar with? Now, even if you're teaching or if you're a student, it applies to you as well. You may have done it in your you know, academic project, and that counts as well. Thirty seconds up. Let's wait for 1 minute and we'll close the poll. Forty seconds up. We're getting a lot of mixed responses, so that's interesting. 50 seconds up, 10 more seconds to go. And we'll close the poll in 5 more seconds to go. Right, 1 minute up, and I'm going to close the poll now and show you the results. So here is it on your screen. 54% is somewhat familiar with simulations, and equal number of people. Now here you could select more than one option, of course. And about 54% are saying, I'm just getting started into the world of simulations. And a very small percentage is saying, I've explored a bit and I'm comfortable with one or more software tools. So clearly, majority of us in this room, the attendees, are getting started to learn about daylight simulation tools. That's good. Now, that brings me to the last question I have, which is now on your screen. Are you familiar with Grasshopper tools? We'll wait for a minute. Again, some of you said you're familiar with tools. Of course, a small percentage, but you're clearly here because you're interested to know about this topic. Mm. 25 seconds up. Forty seconds up. Most of you have voted, maybe just few more people to vote. 50 seconds up, we'll wait for 10 more seconds and we'll close the poll. Okay, closing the poll now and sharing the results here on your screen. 73% are saying, I have heard about it, but I have not used it much. And a very small percentage, like, I've just begun exploring this. So some of you have just begun exploring, whereas majority of you heard about it. So clearly you've heard about it, you find it interesting, and you're here to learn about it. Most of you are not yet working on projects that demand daylight assessment as well. So that's great. Now, that's where I come to my next point, is that everyone here in the audience is, of course, convinced that daylight is integral to climate responsive building design, right? Clearly, we don't have to make a case for this. It's very obvious. And when it comes to whether you call it green building, high performance design, net zero energy building, LEED certified, GRIHA certified, whatever kind of names or tags that the building have, daylight is an expected element in such buildings, right? But to achieve good daylight in the final outcome, it's very important to set the benchmarks during concept stage. So setting benchmark and doing this in concept stage, both are very crucial to do. And of course, this can be easily done when you're aware of the qualitative and the quantitative metrics pertaining to daylight. And secondly, today we use dynamic daylight metrics. So very essential to learn about that. Gone are the days when we only used to rely on static metrics, but now there are tools which allow you to study this in a very easy way. So using simulation tools to explore design options and drive design decisions will actually influence the final outcome. So if you are someone who is part of a design process, then your role, having learned this skill, is very crucial. And this is not a futuristic skill to have. It's now and here. It is expected that now anyone who's interested to whether designing a sustainable building or maybe go into the consulting space has this knowledge of daylight simulations. It's absolutely a necessity. So with this, you are not only using the tool as compliance purpose, but you are using it to drive the design decision, help the design team take the right decision, explore a plethora of options, and finally shape the outcome of the building. And that is the intent behind us designing this course for someone like you who's just beginning your journey into the world of simulations, who has heard about Grasshopper but don't yet know how it works, but you are very much interested to figuring it out. So the intent behind this course is for us to teach you daylight simulation skills. At the end of it, you will have clarity in daylight performance metrics. right? Metrics are both qualitative and quantitative, and you will know about it. It goes beyond compliance. Compliance is just there to give some kind of a benchmark. And as you get more warmed up into this topic, you can you know, have your own metrics for your projects. And finally, we are here to teach you how to analyze the simulation output. It's one thing to learn a tool and just run a simulation, create the 3D and do everything. And it's another thing to actually understand what do you do with this simulation output, this red, blue, and green diagrams that you get from the program. You will be able to give meaningful feedback into the design process with the kind of examples that we have created in this course. So with that, I pass on the presentation controls to my colleague, Vaishali, who will walk you through the course and exactly what is it that this will cover. Over to you, Vaishali.
Thank you, Deepa. I'll just share my screen. I hope you can see my screen.
Yes, we can see your screen.
Okay. So, hi everyone. I am Vaishali. Let me introduce myself a bit. So, I'll be your lead instructor for this course, and I am a senior green building analyst at EDS. I actually work on data-driven design and has conducted various internal and external training programs on high performance buildings, daylighting, and design optimization with the help of these advanced simulation tools. So let's just talk about the course now. So in this particular course, we'll be taking you with the basic modeling through Rhino. We'll be talking about different kind of scripting by using Ladybug and Honeybee tools on Grasshopper. We'll be doing daylighting analysis by using engines like Daysim and Radiance, and we'll let you know how to optimize the design and how to actually work on different parameters of design. So the question comes is how to create a well-daylit space when we talk about a good daylighting in a space. And to do that, we actually need to check if that particular space is well daylit or not, right? So to check that, we use these daylight simulations, and to do that, we need different kinds of tools. So there are a lot of tools available in the market right now. We can use Ecotec, Revit, ISVE, Safaria, Lightstanza, Design Builder, Grasshopper, Rhino, etc. So all these tools are, some of the tools are cloud-based, some of the tools are actually as a simple interface-based, and you can explore any one of them and work on that. But in this particular course, let's see what we will be covering. So this particular course is about computational design tools. We'll be talking about daylight matrix in this course. We'll be talking about daylight compliance for different standards like LEED and ECBC. And then we'll be doing the assessment based on different parameters for improved daylight performance. So the main core thing is we'll be using computational design tools for this particular course. So let me just throw some light on what is computational design. So computational design helps designers or basically non-coders to create design with a set of instructions or algorithms, you can say. So it actually allows you to create designs not just by modeling the geometry directly, but by defining some kind of relationships between smaller processes that come together to create the final outcome. Additionally, it also helps you to think of designs as systems rather than just a static object. So why we are using these computational design tools or computational design nowadays? Actually, it allows designers to be more innovative, insightful, and personalized. Generally, to build these algorithms, computational designers must be familiar with some level of computer programming, which is the practice of writing algorithms to describe specific tasks to a computer, right? So, although computer programming is not traditionally thought as a core design skill, as design workflows becomes more and more digital and complex, the ability to program design tools to do custom things has become increasingly important. And thus, we are using these computational tools to do so. Here are several computational design tools in the market which we can use to do daylighting simulations, like MicroStation, Rhinoceros, Revit, Generative Components, Dynamo, Diva, for Rhino, and Marionette. We will be covering Rhino, basically Grasshopper on Rhino interface, and we will be talking about Ladybug and Honeybee tools to do daylighting simulation on those interfaces. So we'll be, in this particular course, we'll be talking about daylight performance matrix, as Deepa just explained you that the need of the hour is not restricted to static metrics. We are going towards the dynamic matrix. So we'll let you know about how to do simulation based on variable sky condition and how to do simulation based on annual hours. Then we will take you to the compliances of different standards, just like LEED and ECBC. We'll be working on illuminance calculation specifically on LEED, for LEED standards, and we'll be doing UDI analysis based on ECBC standards in this particular course. Also, we'll take you through daylight design parameters like building geometry, radiance materials, and analysis grid. We'll talk about the sky, how sky condition changes each and every aspect of daylighting. Then we'll talk about some of the parameters which can be changed based on the requirement of how much daylight should enter that particular space, like orientation, wall window ratio, and shading devices. So as you can see, this red color bubble you see over here are the some kind of fixed parameters which we use when we are working on daylighting. Sky is dependent on which kind of matrix you will be using for the simulation, and orientation, wall window ratio, and shading devices or material of a glass are those parameters which can be changed to improve daylight, to get a good amount of daylight inside and to cut the glare. So we'll be talking about the workflow here. So we'll be following this kind of a workflow in the whole course. We'll be creating geometry in Rhino. We will refer that particular geometry in Grasshopper. Then we'll use some recipe to add material to set an analysis grid, to create sky, and to add radiance parameter to create the whole recipe all together using Ladybug and Honeybee tools. And at the end, we'll run the simulation on the engines like Radiance and Desi. As you see this diagram here, for some people, those who know about daylighting or about these computational tools, it must be really simple that, okay, we'll be doing this. But for some people, it can be really complex, just like this jumbled up thing over here. So our motive is to take you through this complexity and all the theories all together and create an elegant simplicity so that you understand everything well and you get a pace so that you work further as per your convenience based on your own workflows. With this, let me tell you who can take this course. So any professional involved in designing buildings, any architects, green building consultants or engineers can take this course. Students studying architecture or related discipline can take this course, or any faculty teaching architecture or sustainability in their colleges or related discipline can take this course. So here are some learning objectives which you will take away from this course. You will be able to explain daylight matrix with confidence once you have completed this whole course. You'll be able to execute simulations for daylight factor, point in time, and useful daylight illuminance using Grasshopper. You'll be able to execute daylight compliance for LEED and ECBC specifically. Then you'll be able to assess design parameters for improved daylight performance. Also, once you know all of these things, you will be able to create your own workflows or thresholds based on which you can do analysis on any kind of a building. With this, let me also tell you what this program is not about. So because this is a beginner level course, we are not showing an example of complex multiple zone building or parametric form building. We'll be taking a simple geometry so that each and every one of you can follow along and go into the detail of the tool and as well as the daylighting matrix. We are not here to talk about Python scripting, as we all know that Grasshopper and Ladybug and Honeybee tools are based on Python scripting. So we are not covering that Python scripting part. We'll be just talking about the components. Then we are not here to give you a detailed understanding of radiance parameters or SDA and ASC. And we are not here to talk about glare analysis, as all these topics are an advanced level topics. And we are not covering all these topics in this particular course. With this, let me introduce you to the program format which we will be following in this particular course. So we have this blended learning program in which we'll be having live webinars and recorded video modules. These live webinars will be scheduled just like the one we are having right now. And these recorded videos will be self-paced, which you can take at your ease at any time you want. We'll be having a defined schedule of this program. So we'll let you know when you have to cover which part of the thing, which part of the course, so that you follow along nicely with your own pace. We'll be having 1.5 to 2 hours of live webinar twice per week. We'll be having 2 hours of exclusive classroom session each week, in which we will be clearing all the doubts of the class we'll be having. Then we'll be having 10 recorded video lessons, which you can take as per your own pace. So all in all, this whole thing contains of 26 hours of e-learning comfortably spread over 2 weeks. We'll be taking the live webinars on the GoToWebinar platform. It is a one-time setup. If you are new to this, you must have set up it on your phones or on your desktop. And now you can take any webinar session with us whenever you want. And it is just to attend the live webinars. And also you will be provided with all the recordings once the webinar is over. And it is highly recommended to attend the webinar so that you get the whole gist of how we are taking each step forward. Also, we'll be having a Google Classroom. It will be one place to manage each and everything, your coursework, your assignments, your reference materials, which we will give you. You can also connect with your classmates through this classroom. You can ask questions based on any of your queries. Use it as a discussion forum all in all. So basically, here we'll be able to take you through the whole, take you through like a whole class, and we'll discuss each and everything based on what we'll be doing in each week. Then here comes the schedule of this whole program. We'll be meeting 3 times in a week, that is on Monday, Wednesday, and Sunday. Are the times written based on different time zones. It will be mostly stretched for 2 hours, 1.5 to 2 hours. So we have mentioned that for India, it is 6 to 8 IST. Then we have 4:30 to 6:30 for UAE time, 12:30 to 2:30 GMT, and 8:30 to 10:30 AM EST. In week 2 also, we'll follow the same schedule. We'll be meeting 3 times in a week. All these webinars will be every week on Mondays and Wednesdays from 6 p.m. onwards to 7:30 to 8 p.m. We'll clear all the theoretical concepts in these webinars. We'll make you understand daylight simulation process, inference of the results, and we'll also introduce you with the assignments. Then we'll be having these 10 pre-recorded video lessons, which will be self-paced. It will actually be detailed on how to do, how to work with the tool. It will have all the tool demonstration of the tool so that you can follow along whenever you want. And if you even get interrupted with something in the middle, you can just go back and watch each and every second as per your own pace. And as each and every one of you won't be that familiar with the software, it will be helpful for you to get along with the software once you are looking at the recorded videos. Also, we'll be providing all the scripts and Rhino models which we'll be using in each and every lesson. Then we have these classroom hours every week on Sunday, which will be 6 to 8 p.m. We'll discuss all the assignments given in the last webinar in these classroom session, and we will revisit any concept or tool demo if required. And you can always ask anything about previous modules in the session. Basically, it will be a doubt clearing session for all of you. Then we have these assignments. We'll be introducing you with the assignments every Wednesday after each webinar. And there'll be total number of 3 assignments. You can apply what you have learned based on these assignments. The focus on the topic will be that which is covered in that particular module during the whole week. And each assignment is interconnected. So it is recommended that all of you work on each and every assignment so that you get along with the whole thing altogether. Here are a few key takeaways or learnings you will get from this course. You'll be able to develop skills of working with computational tools for daylight analysis. You'll be able to validate design for compliance with LEED and ECBC. You will create a technical knowledge of these tools, which is Rhino and Grasshopper. You'll also get all the copy of all the course materials, scripts, and models. You'll be interacting with us and the expert faculty to answer all your queries. And at the end of the program, you will get a course completion certificate. And it will be provided once you will submit all the assignments only. So it is really recommended to work on the assignments. So as I have just explained the whole course brief, let me tell you how you can register for this course. So we have the registrations open right now. We have the pricing as 5,500 INR for students, 7,500 for professionals. We have our early bird ending today, which is 5,000 till today. So you can actually register today and get avail this particular discount. Otherwise, from tomorrow, we'll be having the cost mentioned over here. So you can go to our link. We'll be providing you with the link here also, and you can also get it through our any of LinkedIn or Instagram page. So you can just register now if you feel that you want to be the part of this particular program. Here is the program team. I am Vaishali, your program instructor. Then I'll be having Anushma and Omkar with me. They both are also green building analysts at EDS. They work on diverse projects of LEEDS Griha IGBC certification and design optimization. We have Nikita as our program coordinator, who also works with different certification projects and also works with our education team. Then we have Anam, who is our social media outreach person, who is the person helping us to reach to all of you. And she is also green building analyst at EDS. You will also meet our expert panel. One of them is Mr. Guneet Singh. He is director of EDS and a daylight expert and has a great experience of working with diverse projects all around the world. Then we have Mr. Abhishek Jain, who is associate director at EDS, and he is also a daylight expert and worked on various projects all over the world. So with this session, I will take you through some questions now, which we have got since we have floated this whole program. So there are a few questions which I'll just directly take as FAQs here. So some people have asked us that what do I need to bring to the program? So the answer is just a personal laptop and good internet connection to attend the program. Then the other question is, what if I am not able to attend the webinar? So our answer to this is try not to miss any webinar. But in case you are not able to attend the webinar, please send an email informing the instructor about your absence. And also, you can get the recording afterwards once you don't have, if you haven't attended the webinar. Then there's a question on, can I get access to the webinar recordings? Yes, all webinars will be recorded and available to the registered participants in the classroom, as I mentioned before. Then the question is, can I have access to the online self-paced modules after the program is over? Yes, you will continue to have access to all course material after the program is over. Then the next question is, can I attend the webinar through my phone? Yes, you can. But for an effective learning experience, we recommend using your laptop or desktop so that you have a better experience and you can look to the things which we are talking about more clearly. Then the next question is, the schedule looks extensive. I'm busy with my work and classes. How do I optimize my time? So the answer to this is webinars are twice a week. So you can plan your time in advance and be consistent. Also, if you feel there is some issue with the schedule or something, you can talk to us, you can write to us, and we will see if we could arrange for some other times as well. Should I have any prior knowledge in Rhino or Grasshopper to join this course? No, this course is designed for beginners. So basic knowledge of 2D modeling is essential. That's it. Otherwise, you can join it and we'll take you through from zero to advanced level. Should I have any prior knowledge in daylighting simulation? No, this course is specifically designed for beginners. So you don't need to have any prior knowledge of daylighting simulation. We will teach you from the scratch. The other question is, what are the PC configurations and software requirements for this course? So the softwares used are compatible with these OS, Windows 64-bit, Mac OS 10.3.6 and higher, and you need to use Windows 8.1 and higher to work on these softwares. Which are the softwares used? So we are using Rhino 6, and it is not free. You need to download and install a 90 days trial, and it is available. Also, Grasshopper is inbuilt in Rhino 6. In case you are using Rhino 5, you can download it as a plugin from Grasshopper forum. Also, there are Ladybug tools, Honeybee tools, which we will be using in this course, which can also be downloaded. And we have Radiance and Daysim as open source software. So all these tools are open source, so you can get it directly from the net. Also, we will be providing a step-by-step manual in which we will be telling you how to actually install each and every software and take you through the whole process. With this, now I would like to take questions from the live audience. So let me check what all questions we have.
Vaishali, I have yes. those questions here. So you can, it's easier. Yeah, would you like to take these few questions?
Yeah, on the screen? Okay. I'll take that. So the first question is, will you provide a student license? So as I just explained that Rhino 6 has a free trial for 90 days. So you can download that and use it in the course. And Grasshopper is inbuilt in Rhino 6 and requires no separate installation. So you can directly use it. And also for other plugins, they are all open source and we'll be providing you a step-by-step guide to install and work on those. So the second question is, how is it helpful to me as I am not a designer but a project manager? Okay, so I think Deepa, you'll be taking this. Deepa, are you there?
Yes, I can hear. Right. Yeah. So that's a wonderful question. We have, we've conducted so many programs and we have people at very senior position at the director level also enroll for our program, which is meant for a beginner level. Right. So what we would say is that, you know, as a project manager, you would be leading a team and managing a project where there will be team members or other consultants who would be working on these daylight simulations. But as a manager, if you have a high level understanding of what simulations output look like, what kind of feedback is possible to give from these outputs, what are the different possibilities that these tools present, then that's a very useful information to have as a project manager. So since it's a beginner level course, it's very appropriate for you since you're not a designer. So you want to look at it, just in terms of what kind of feedback and what kind of output is possible using these tools. And with that much of understanding, you'll be, it's a useful knowledge to have and you'd find it very practical in your day-to-day work as well. So from that perspective, this course will be helpful to you. Yeah, so we move on to the next question from Varada. So can you see the screen, Vaishali?
Yes. So we have a question here. Can you provide software setup link for installation? So once you enroll with us, we'll provide you with the whole set of manual and essential setup links, and we'll also give you a detailed installation manual. So we have everything set up with us. Once you enroll with us, we'll provide you with the same. So the next question is there a minimum OS configuration that is required for these software to run? So Linux is not compatible for OS specifically. We need to have Windows 8.1 or 10. For Mac OS, we need to have 10.13.6 or higher format. Then for Mac OS, we need to have 10.14.6 and Mac OS 10.15.3. So that's the configurations we have. We need for running these softwares. Then the next question is, you mentioned that the course is not for modeling complex multi-zone spaces. So can I apply concepts from the course to models, from this course to models, say a high-rise building with multiple space types for LEED ECBC compliance? Yeah. So basically, we are actually working on a smaller project. But once you get to know all these tools and these components, you will be able to do that on your own. And in case you need any assistance from us, we'll be there to help you out. So the course structure is made in such a way so that all beginners can apply all those things in this 2-week program. And once you are well equipped with the tools and you know how to work on the smaller project, you'll be able to work on the bigger projects as well. Then next question is, can we use the concepts learned in your course at city level daylighting analysis? So for city level daylighting analysis, I don't know. I haven't heard of this term like that. Basically, we normally work on radiation when we talk about city level thing. So I'm not sure what you are asking about this. If you can elaborate on this, then I'll take this question again. The next question is, I want to create a daylighting envelope for an urban farm in a particular area. What would it be possible to do? Yeah, that is possible to do. And also you can run the simulation on any particular surface. But then you need to be very particular about what all parameters are affecting the whole grid on which you are doing the analysis. So I think we are done with the questions.
There is, yes, just one more question.
Okay.
Just one second.
Okay, yeah, I can see this question on the box. So the question is, though we will not go into details of glare analysis, will we touching upon glare index in small part so that we could be able to explore them later? So yes, we will be talking about the values which actually caters or which actually led to glare. We'll be talking about the thresholds which are more than a certain limit which actually causes glare, but we will not do any kind of glare analysis to counter that glare. We will not about those DGP values to work on the glare analysis part, but you will get an overall understanding that what is glare. And if you have any more questions, you can just type it down in the chat box and we can take those as well.
So if you've enjoyed the interaction with us, if we've clarified all your questions, today is the last day to register for the program to avail the early bird discount. Otherwise, registrations are open until 21st. We've sent the link to you in the chat box. Please avail the early bird opportunity right away. It's the last day today. And we're here for a minute. If you still have any questions, then we can take them. You can connect with us on social media and follow us for updates with, you know, the other upcoming programs and all the other work that we are doing in this space.
So we have one more question over here, Deepa. I'll just take this. So
yeah, sure.
The question is, can you also help us in doing daylighting analysis in Ecotech? Yeah, we can actually help you with that, but this course is not focusing on that. We might have another course on that, and then you can join us for that. Thank you.
Thank you so much. We hope to see you soon in our program. I hope you enjoy today's session.
Thank you, everyone.